Of course, in a real world scenario, we would angle these more towards the sun so that we get the maximum output. Oh look, it's moving. I just saw it move again. Look. Oh my goodness, I love seeing that. Good morning, everyone. We're here at Pasig City Hall on the rooftop with our Starlink. In fact, I've just been showing this to Mayor Vehicle, and I would not be surprised if they end up buying some of these for the city. As I mentioned in my previous video, I've joined Pasig City in the past during their relief operations, rescue operations, and now I want to join them again, but with Starlink, so that when they have their operations, they can provide internet to their own guys for communications, for coordination, but also provide internet to the residents there that were affected by the typhoon, the flooding, the earthquake, whatever it might be. So let's talk to Sir Bryant Wong, head of DRRMO here in Pasig City, and ask him, how can we put this to good use during your operations?
We need redundancy in case of disaster, that there's no available internet, there's no available telco, there's no available antenna for telcos. And this one is a satellite-driven internet. So this is the redundancy that we're looking for also. Because us DRRMO officers, we need to find new ways and other innovations and technologies on how to have redundancy in everything. So these are charge controllers and solar panels. So normally these solar panels and charge controllers, we can use this one to power any gadget.
This portable solar kit is owned by Pasig City, by their DRRMO, and they just plugged it in and the Starlink moved. So that's a good sign. Now this little controller here actually has a battery inside. So not only does it take power from the solar panels, but it also has a battery inside that gets charged. I think you'll probably need a bigger solar panel than that if you're going to run this for a long time. Of course, in a real world scenario, we would angle these more towards the sun so that we get the maximum output. Oh look, it's moving. I just saw it move again, look. Oh my goodness, I love seeing that. It's looking for the satellite. Oh my goodness, let's do a speed test. 80, 150, 160. I'll cut in a screenshot, but I got around 200 down and then I got around 140 down. A little bit of a difference there because someone else was doing a speed test at the same time. So obviously that 200 is shared between multiple people. Okay, so 50, nice. 60, 70, 100. Just to show you where Bryant's standing, he's here. And then the Starlink is over there, connected to the solar. What was your top speed? Wow, 201 down.
And another one is the generator set.
Okay, can we go take a look at the generator? So this is obviously a portable unit. Do you have bigger ones also?
Yeah, we have bigger gen sets. It depends on the need of what to power. So normally we could use this portable one because it's much lighter compared to the bigger ones.
Here's another option for powering it. One of their portable generators. Okay, let's see, the Starlink should have a light underneath and then we should see the satellite start moving. At the moment, the Starlink is still pointing to the sky. That means it's trying to work out exactly where it is. Once it moves, we should have our internet connection. It's pretty windy here, but we do have a clear sky all the way around us. And there you go, the satellite just moved. That means we should have a connection. Looks like it's pointing in a different direction compared to earlier. I'm not sure how well you'll be able to see this on the camera, but let's try and do a speed test. Okay, how are we doing? 50, 60, 100, 150, 170, 190, 200, 210. Wow, I should record my screen. So we have the generator, the Starlink, and then there's six or seven guys over there, plus me connected to it. They're all streaming YouTube, Netflix, and other things just to test it. Now, of course, in real world scenario, what they'll be using it for is communications and for coordination. Although people who are stuck in the relief centers, they will be grateful because it gets so boring. Yes, there's food, there's water that will always be provided either by the LGU, by private donors. But entertainment, it gets boring, especially when you have children. They're locked in the relief center. They can't go anywhere. They have nothing to do. At least they can still watch Cocomelon. They can play their favorite games, PUBG. Although we do have to talk about latency, but we're gonna save that for a future video. But yeah, very, very impressive. It's very sunny out here, but look, this is a Linus Tech Tips video. Let's jump ahead. See that? It instantly seeks forward. Jump ahead again. So what's this machine here that you have?
This machine is a text messaging alert system. It's more of a, wherein you could send messages to people about 1.5 to 2 kilometers radius by using this machine. You just need to type the message in the laptop and send it afterwards.
So even if there's no cell service, this device acts like a cell tower.
Yeah.
And anyone within 1 to 2 kilometers will receive your message.
It's a one-way communication.
Right.
So it's more of messaging the people surrounding you rather than getting their message.
What kind of message might you send to people?
Alert. We need to alert the people that there's a possible earthquake, there's an earthquake, or also if there's flooding in the area, or maybe other stuff, like what we did in Batangas before, wherein we send the message to the people that Pasig City, DRRMO, or Pasig City is here to help the one who are affected by the Taal volcano.
What are you holding now, and what's the box?
So this is our mobile repeater. It's a VHF repeater for our two-way radios. Normally, we use this for operation wherein we don't have any signals. And through this one, you could just bring this case wherever you want, like the one we did in Batangas. And this one is the antenna of this mobile repeater. And you just need a cord for this one, and you put it on a higher level or a higher ground, so you could have a better signal for this one.
A big thank you to Pasig City and the DRRMO who deal with disaster relief, rescue and things like that. I can't wait to join you guys when you go out on the field and you really serve the people. I've joined you before and I'll join you again, but this time I'll be with the Starlink.